Hi, I'm Fred Opalinski, and I am delighted to read a book to you today. This one is called Sophie Sleeps Over, and it's written by Marisa Bino Russo. Sophie Sleeps Over. From the first day of kindergarten, Sophie and Olive were best bunny friends. They both snacked on carrots and cabbage and kale. They both wore tiaras and bracelets and bows. They both played jumping rope and hopscotch and tag. And of course, they both loved ping pong. What bunny doesn't, right? One day, as Sophie and Olive were walking home from school, Olive said, "For my birthday, I'm going to have a sleepover party, and you're invited." "Sleepover parties are my favorite kind," said Sophie, even though she had never been to one. Sophie went home and made a list of what she thought she would need at Olive's sleepover party. A rainbow t-shirt, ping pong paddle, and tiara. Three important things for a sleepover. Mama suggested pajamas and a toothbrush. Daddy suggested a sleeping bag and a pillow. "And what about Turnip?" said Mama. Turnip was Sophie's favorite doll. Sophie shook her head. She always slept with Turnip, but she didn't want Olive to think she was a baby. Turnip's going to stay home. The day of Olive's sleepover party, Sophie stuffed everything she needed into a big pillowcase, except for her tiara, which she wore on her head. She carried a box wrapped in purple tissue paper, Olive's favorite color. "My first sleepover party," thought Sophie. She was happy from the tops of her ears to the tips of her toes. Doesn't she look great, especially with that tiara, huh? But when the door opened at Olive's house, instead of Olive, there was a bunny Sophie had never seen before. "Who are you?" asked the bunny. For a moment, Sophie thought maybe she had gone to the wrong house. "My name is Sophie. Who are you?" "I'm Penelope," said the bunny. "I am Olive's best friend." "No, I'm her best friend," said Sophie. But all of a sudden, she wasn't so sure. First, the three bunnies played ping pong. Even though Sophie loved to play ping pong, she kept missing the ball, and then she tripped, and her tiara went flying. "I guess I'm not very good at ping pong today," said Sophie, brushing off her skirt. "Are you good at math?" asked Penelope. "You could just keep score." Sophie wasn't very good at math, and she didn't want to keep score. She wanted to go home. After ping pong, it was time to decorate cupcakes. There were sprinkles and candies and little tubes of frosting. "I love cupcakes," said Penelope. "Carrot is my favorite." "Mine too," said Olive. "Actually, I kind of like broccoli cupcakes," said Sophie. "Yuck," said Penelope and Olive at the same time. Sophie looked at the clock. Maybe it wasn't too late to call Mama. But when Olive said, "It's time to play pin the tail on the raccoon," Sophie decided she could call Mama later. There is the raccoon looking for a tail. Got one on his face, do you see that? Olive went first because it was her birthday. Her tail ended up by the raccoon's nose. Penelope went next and her tail ended up by the raccoon's front paw, see that? Finally, it was Sophie's turn. She put the tail right where it belonged. "You're the winner," said Olive. Were you peeking? Asked Penelope. That's cheating, said Olive, and Sophie would never cheat. See, I really am Olive's best friend, thought Sophie. Now she didn't want to go home at all. When Olive started to open her presents, Penelope shouted, Mine first! Olive ripped the paper, and there was a box of paints. Thank you, Penelope, she said. Then Olive opened Sophie's gift. Out of the purple tissue, she pulled a wooden frame with a photograph of her and Sophie. On the frame, Sophie had painted flowers and the words, Best Friends. Wait, I thought I was your best friend, Olive, said Penelope. You are, said Olive, but so is Sophie. That's dumb, said Penelope. A best friend means one friend, not two. No, it doesn't, said Olive. Sophie didn't say anything, but she kind of agreed with Penelope. And then it was time for the bunnies to get into their sleeping bags. Can we have blueberry pancakes for breakfast? Asked Olive when her mother came in to turn out the lights. Of course, said Olive's mother. Now sleep tight, little bunnies, and don't stay up all night. Don't they look cute in their sleeping bags? Soon Sophie could hear soft snoring. The clock on the wall ticked and talked. She looked around the room. The shadows were all wrong. She rolled this way and that. She felt scrunched in her sleeping bag, and worst of all, she missed Turnip. Sophie got up and walked to the window. Suddenly a voice said, What are you doing? Sophie jumped, but it was only Penelope standing right beside her. I can't sleep, whispered Sophie. Me neither, said Penelope. This is my first sleepover, said Sophie. Mine too, said Penelope. And I didn't bring my favorite doll to sleep with, said Sophie. Me neither, said Penelope. I didn't want Olive to think I was a baby. The two bunnies stood by the window and looked at the shadows of the trees. They listened to the hoot-hoot of an owl. Penelope showed Sophie the Big Dipper and the Little Dipper in the starry night sky. Penelope knew all about the stars. At last, Sophie yawned and said, I am getting sleepy. Penelope yawned and said, Me too. They both got back into their sleeping bags. Maybe Olive's right, whispered Penelope. Maybe it's okay to have two best friends. I guess you can never have too many, said Sophie. They both listened to Olive snoring. The clock on the wall ticked and talked. Tomorrow morning there would be blueberry pancakes and ping pong and maybe even time for some jump rope. Jump rope was always better with three. Sophie was happy, from the tops of her ears to the tips of her toes. And before long, she was fast asleep.